In the previous set of problems, what we did was draw the three lines. And to do that, we started at the y-intercept, which is just a point. And from that point, we moved rise over run, basically left the line and returned to the line using the slope, and drew a point. Then we joined those two points and said that that line reflects the equation of the line. So, what do we get out of that? In general, you need a slope and a point to draw a line, or you need two points. Okay? So, that's to draw a line. What about from the slope? So, for this, for example, in this question, given a slope and a point, can you make the equation of the line? So, that's what we're going to do next. So, we can draw this. We could draw this out. We could start at point 2 minus 1. Now, this is not a y-intercept, but we can draw this. So let's do that. 2 minus 1 puts us here. And from here, we're going to use the slope, 1.5. Slope is equal to 1.5, and you can think of that as 1.5 over 1. Or you can think of that as 3 halves. Those are all the same thing. This is the change in y over the change in x. So from this point, we move, let's do it this way, 3, 2. So we're going to move 2 over, so 1, 2, and up 3. 1, 2, 3. So we're going to put a dot there and then join the dots. And in joining the dots, I see that the line will extend down to the y-intercept. And in fact, we could kind of guess what the y-intercept would be to create the equation of a line, because we already have a slope. But let's calculate it, okay? Let's see how we do that. From the graph, it looks that it should intercept at minus 4. So let's see what happens. Call this line 4. Okay, so let's take the equation of a line, which we're going to use the form y equals a plus bx. And let's plug in what we know. We know that b is 1.5, it's the slope. We don't know a. But we do know one pair of x and y. So this is one point. So let's use these values. X would be 2, and y would be minus 1. And let's use that to solve for a, which should be true for all pairs that fall on the line. So this is 3. So we can take 3 to this side. In other words, we're going to get minus 1 minus 3. So minus 1 minus 3 is a. So as we expected, a will be minus 4. To finish this, we have to express the equation of a line. So let's do that with blue. The equation of a line would be y equals minus 4 plus 1.5x. And this is mathematically the equation of this line that extends out to infinity on both ends.